I'm Sir Tapped Up, and welcome to Let's Play Epic Battle Fantasy 3, the Steam version. So this just went up on Steam a couple days ago with some brand new features and nothing too major, but it does have this nice speed multiplier. It also has a frame skip option for crappier computers. I should be pretty good here. I'm editing a video while I record this, so maybe I shouldn't be too bold, but this is a free game, and the original free Flash version still available on plenty of sites, on Newgrounds and such. But this is the slightly enhanced free Steam version. Matt's basically described it as an advertisement for EBF4, which is not free on Steam, but pretty cool way to advertise a game, in my opinion. Just as a sort of disclaimer, Matt Rusak does develop this game, does back my patron. I wasn't paid for this video in particular or anything, but I've been friends with him on Twitter for a while, so just, standard disclosure stuff there. Oh man, this takes me back. I first played this in college. I want to say, what year was this? Course, there's a credit for that. Originally published 2010, so I would have been, it would have been my senior year. That was senior, junior. I guess it depends, but design, story, artwork, Matt Kupo-Rusak, music by Furana, as always. He said that he changed the ad, so it's just an ad for Bullet Heaven 2 and Epic Battle Fantasy 4, which are both on Steam now. There's only so high the resolution will go. I think you can full screen, I'm not sure exactly how that looks. I'm already recording, and I don't want to mess it up, so I'm just going to start a new game. Alright, he added some new fan art into the thingy. This game's been developed for a lot. Oh yeah, I remember waiting for a long time for Epic Battle Fantasy. Yeah, you gotta unlock with achievements, I think? It's got a bunch of... This was one of the first games I played with achievements off, like, console, actually. When did PlayStation even add achievements? Like, they were kind of late to that. Yeah. Oh, and I actually really like the difficulty. It seems kind of, like, simple, like, basic, Foes do 30% more damage, 60% more damage to other bonuses. Foes are 30% weaker. It's simple, but it works. And, we're going to play on easy because, I'm just trying to show off this game here. It's not a big deal. But you can actually, even with the most basic stuff like that, another game I need to play that is Defender's Quest, the new enhanced edition. You just give people, some options to customize their experience. Even if it's really simple, it can help a lot. So, when I first played this, I have a video on YouTube from years ago where I did not a full Let's Play, because, this game's pretty long. It's not super long as far as RPGs go, but it's pretty long as far as Flash games go. I forget exactly how long. But I just did a video of Akron at, the hard difficulty. And that's a pretty good challenge. It's, I was calling it simple and stuff, but it works out pretty well. And monoliths are really brutal. This is the Epic Battle Fantasy game that taught everyone to fear the monoliths. Anyway, a few years ago, a great battle against evil an evil entity rocked the Earth. The destruction left the population enfeebled and struggling to survive. A mighty warrior, Lance the Gunner, took this opportunity to conquer the lands. However, he was probably defeated by Matt the Swordsman and Natalie the Magician. Following this battle, the three young heroes teamed up, hoping that no new evil force would defeat their combined power, and once more bring chaos to the world. The trio spent their days hunting treasure and challenging new opponents. Eventually, legends and rumors led them to an ancient tomb, the resting place of a powerful deity. To their surprise, it seemed that this being was still alive, merely imprisoned and reduced to deep sleep. Curiously, the three prodded the chained demon. The demon quickly awoke with a violent shockwave, through blinking. At least Nats is blinking. The trio were stunned and unable to retaliate as a powerful magic tugged at their souls. The demon began to drain their life energy. As the heroes were so powerful, their combined energy was too much for them to absorb, so they survived the ordeal. However, the power of the demon was so dense that it began to distort space and time around them, forming a void of nothingness. The Drew awoke, they found themselves in a foreign land. With most of their powers drained and their equipment scattered throughout the continent, they were reduced to the status of ordinary adventurers. They would not give up until they had remedied the situation. Clearly, it was not just their problem, but the entire world's. An ancient and mysterious deity, now possessing their combined powers, was free to lay waste to the lands. Oh, by the way, use WASD or the arrow keys to move around and space to interact with stuff. And more escape will open the menu. I don't believe this has... Nah, it doesn't have controller support. This is a fairly simple port, you know. For free, how much are you gonna expect? Parker! I'm expecting Parker to frickin' poke me in the butt with spikes. Or claws, rather. Claws are spikes for cats, you know. What just happened? I told you guys not to touch that thing. Felt my magic being drained from me. I don't think I can use it now. It looked dead. It smelled dead, too. Never expected anything like this to happen. It's probably still out there, doing who knows what. Well, I guess we landed pretty far away. This landscape is unfamiliar. Looks like a farm in some village? Guess we better have a look around. I just want my swords back. I spent years stealing those. That's not an immediate concern, but I guess we'll recover our skills and weapons at some point if we're gonna fight that guy again. You got items. So this is the first entry in the Epic Battle Fantasy series that works like a, you know, more of a standard RPG. We've got walking around, we've got talking to people. You're in the town, doesn't have a name, because it's the only town in the game. So, Matt said he didn't bother to fix a lot of the typos and stuff in the game. It's just sort of the sort of sense of humor that the game had. It sort of lends itself to its, you know, slightly low-quality feel. You know, not like bad, but, you know, quick stuff, cheap humor, that sort of stuff. Feel free to wander around the shops, too, but you don't look like you have much money. Thanks? So, the earlier Epic Battle Fantasy games were, alright, someone has that teleport, too. The earlier Epic Battle Fantasy games were, basically just boss rushes, but, like, the entire game is that, and it was actually pretty neat. Some people were actually upset that the game switched to a more traditional sort of, RPG thing, though it's still really condensed, and I like that. Aha, our first dungeon. Doesn't look very interesting, though. Maybe we'll at least find some decent creatures to eat. We're not here to hunt innocent animals. I guess it's alright to euthanize some if they get in our way. We should get through this place in 5 minutes. I don't want you two messing around. Let's hurry and visit the tougher levels so we can hunt real monsters, not feeble forest vermin. I concur. Let's slaughter everything that moves and get out of here. I forgot these people had names. So yeah, you can talk to people, you get stuff. So the way this game works, like I said, it's a pretty condensed. You snails, remove them, please. They do look rather pathetic, but they seem to be blocking some paths. The extermination efforts will be rewarded. So, like I said, it's a condensed RPG, so there's... All the screens are pretty tight in terms of, like, you're gonna find a lot of loot really fast. Dungeons are maybe, like, 10 screens max, I would say. Music's really good, as always. Oh, and Matt did some changes to how stuff works, like... I think scanning and element stuff works like it does in Epic Battle Fantasy 4. Yeah, you have scan, don't you? Was it the fact that you can see scans on any level? Was that new in 4 or not? It's been so long since I played this. I basically haven't played this since... I forgot this was just the normal battle theme. This is really good. I think... Yeah, all of the Epic Battle Fantasy soundtracks can be found over on Bandcamp, just Furana's Bandcamp. Just you can just search Furana Bandcamp or Epic Battle Fantasy Bandcamp. You can actually get physical copies for a couple of them. I believe I have all of the physical ones that there are things of. 3, 4, and Battle Fantasy 2. I want to say there's a fourth one. Was there a Bullet Heaven one? I think I got all the ones that were available. I remember I had to buy one from her from eBay. This guy's pretty big. I'm sure he's got the same weaknesses as the little slimes, though. Wonder what kinds of attacks he's got. So the game just kind of gives you a tutorial through dialogue. And I'm not sure if we'll actually, like, die. Oh, I forgot. I probably should have, like, actually learned some spells and stuff. That's fine. Let's just kill the small ones first, then. it's been really cool to watch Matt's games and the Epic Battle Fantasy series sort of grow in general. I would be honest, I was feeling a little worried when he made his first mobile game, Cat Cafe. I wasn't sure where we were going with that, but it seems he's back to making, you know, good old PC games, and it seems like Steam stuff has been a success. Some people don't want Flash games on Steam. Those people are assholes. What you use to make a game doesn't change whether it's a good game or not. You know, some bad games use Unity. A lot of really great games use Unity. You know, just because it's easy to use, you know, it does mean that some people that aren't good at games will make it, but it also means a lot of people will get their start making good games in it. And, Flash gets a bad rap. It's for making games and animations. You know, it's an animation program. It's not an adware program. It's not a video player. But the reason people hate Flash is because they just used it for all of the wrong purposes. And, well, I think such damage won't kill me. You might be wrong about that, buddy. I probably should have gone in, and this game actually has a ability point sort of system. Oh, I forgot. So in Epic Battle Fantasy 4, Natalie Staffs pretty much always casts spells when she attacks, but not in Epic Battle Fantasy 3. Something so huge, he wasn't so tough after all. Although, this game actually introduced me to something that I actually really like, and I haven't seen too many RPGs do. Equipment has, I think you usually have to upgrade them, but like, say like there's a woolly mammoth outfit in the game, and it means a woolly mammoth will counter for you if you take damage sometimes, and like, these skills have like these passive chances of casting spells and stuff, and it's actually really cool. Also, I think he upgraded or improved how fast you heal while walking. Though unlike Epic Battle Fantasy 4, we don't see how fast we're healing, so. Oh, yep, all the way back to full health. Okay. Oh, by the way, something that way too few RPGs do is let you speed up the gameplay and stuff. That's something I never really thought about until, yes. Aw, crap, I only have... Alright. Just get the pathetic things that I can. I never really thought about until I played Disgaea 3, and, a lot of people think Disgaea is grindier than it really is. Well, these guys look weak. Looks like one or two hits should bring him down. Disgaea is a game that you can do amazing grinding stuff in, but it's not a game where you have to do that. Nice, I've learned a fire spell. That should wipe out these brush and slime enemies quick. But then, and also in Hyperdimension Neptunia, actually has a lot of really good features for reducing grind. You can like skip, oh, and now you see, whenever you get a status effect, it says what it is out loud. Well, not out loud, but you know what I mean. Can I kill it with this? No, whatever. Yeah, like Hyperdimension Neptunia, you can just hold a button to skip animations at any time. I think Disgaea has that too, I'm pretty sure, yeah. And we just crawled to a tree. I did not sign up for this. Isn't nature great? Nats is awesome. I remember waiting for this thing on like horrible internet. Well, I had DSL at home and I had like super fast cable at college. But I remember when Flash games used to be like, oh man, it's 5 megabytes? Come on, man. Let's make sure you use your scan ability. Yeah. I guess we get a lot of tutorials before we start getting more jokes and stuff, but this game has it's slightly like how in Final Fantasy X, there's some incidental dialogue that happens the first time certain events occur, like, I can't think of any good examples off the top of my head, but like, they'll pop a joke when like the first time certain characters die or stuff like that. I always thought it was really cool in Final Fantasy X. I used my 5 for that. See, that's an example there. Humor isn't for everyone, but you know, it's... Like I said, it's that cheap, but you know, tends to be effective sort of humor. You know, it's what the game originally was, and you know, It wasn't like it was he was gonna like totally change it, but I actually kind of like having just a really good but faithful version of a classic game, and in my opinion, Flash games classics too. Oh man, I miss having targeted attack or like multi-target attacks. But I won't play this too long. I mean, maybe if we see, you know, I'll play to the first boss. I just wanted to show this off. You know, it's free on Steam. You can play it on Newgrounds. The one thing that I really hated about Flash games, so easy to lose your save file. I lost my save file for this game, and I think this. Let me confirm this. Okay, this doesn't have cloud save, but I think Epic Final Fantasy IV does? Or was it? Bullet Heaven definitely does. Okay, so this doesn't have cloud save, and that might be because it's Flash. Well, I'm not sure if this is Adobe Air or Flash, but the file will... Is someone farming bacon out here? Might as well grab one. Aww. I'll finally leave the pigs alone. Take the molester. Coffee revives a fallen ally. Okay. Oh, I forgot those pop-ups. I really like that you can just ignore those pop-ups and it's fine, or you can hover over them. Areas like this should have hidden treasure passages. Oh, hello. Also, there's a lot of unique equipment you find buried and stuff. Yeah, I've been thinking, I haven't, wait, I think this is... Oh, I also really liked something about this game. So equipment has percentage buffs to your base stats. You know, like you don't change equipment because, you know, oh, this has only one attack and this one has like 5,000. You know, your weapons stay relevant forever, and I actually really love that about this game. I think more RPGs could do with stuff like that. So, Avenger. I think I usually went with the axe at this point in the game. Alright, can we get some more skills? No. I want to at least get Nat's skills. I actually really like, just as an RPG in general, I really like how this game approaches stuff. Like, it keeps things simple, but it keeps the combat really fun. And, like I said, the equipment is really... You know, the equipment feels good. I think we gotta beat the turtle. Hit the enemies until they die. I think you're resistant against rock, right? Yeah. Oh wait, no you're not. I would usually scan all of these, but I'm just kind of rushing. I also really liked how scan was a permanent thing. You know, there's a lot of... it's really frustrating how few RPGs really look at the user experience and, like, try to make things efficient and enjoyable. And, like, that's something what I need to write some articles about. Actually, when I started my website, SirTapDog.com, one of the things I meant to do was, like, write a whole series of user experience articles on, like, RPG design and stuff, and I still plan to do that. So the forest is getting thicker. Nuh-uh, I don't mind if you kill the slimy ones. You have a slimy heart. Ugh. Oh, I have to... Oh, you have to come around from the other side. So you can just kind of ignore a lot of battles. But yeah, I like when games give you options. Like I said, Neptunia, there's almost always some way to circumvent most of the grind. Sometimes there's stuff. Wait. Alright, so it's two screens over. I think it's on the other side of this ridge. Yeah, it is. I'm gonna fight this bee. Hello, sir.
My boy, there be monsters all over the place. Help out in the main room. Give me some shroobs.
Okay. So we're almost out of the forest. Hopefully don't end up in a swamp or something instead. Our first boss battle is epic! Don't just get your hopes up. The boss is probably a giant vegetable. It probably is. If we smack that cat about, it'll drop candy. Aw. Cat violence is unfortunately common in these games. I don't have thunder yet. Okay, let's burn it. Aww. What was I saying? Yeah, Matt seems to really get a lot of stuff about how, you know, RPGs can be enjoyable for, you know, the gameplay aspects. And way too few RPGs, at least, you know, big time Japanese RPGs, seem to really get that, you know. I do enjoy playing a game for story sometimes, but I'm not one of those people that think, oh, turn-based games, you know, turn-based games are outdated. You can't enjoy a turn-based game. You only can play that for the story. It's like, well, no. Some of us enjoy a little bit of strategy in our games. And, you know. And turn-based, you know, you can do stuff in turn-based that you simply can't in a real-time game. That's why I'm concerned about the Final Fantasy VII remake. Like, you can't have a full party of, you know, three constantly active people. Stupid thing in here. Wait, can I poison bees? You know, you can't use... wait, maybe ice is good against them. Eh, whatever. Like, you can't use the same strategies that you could in the original Final Fantasy VII. Because, you know, you had three people out there at once, you had a whole huge menu, and, like, maybe, you know, with a properly set up magic and stuff menu, you could have, like, 100 actions at your fingertips and select any one of them within, you know, 5 seconds. That's not going to happen in a real-time combat system. You know, that's just not how real-time stuff works. Real-time is fun, but it's different. It's not better. You know, you can do, and you don't have necessarily the time to think, and, oh, I can't get around it. Dang, you heal really fast in this one. I remember having to walk around back and forth quite a lot. But yeah, since you auto-regain, you might as well auto-regain, you know, quickly. I guess I may as well just learn one of each. Slash. Sure. I guess I'm probably gonna be using that the most. Just gonna want to get to that boss. That horse does not look suspicious at all. Look at its eyes! Oh my god. I'm not used to him not having a. Doesn't he? I guess no, he doesn't. Wait. Doesn't he get a fire attack? Or is that only in 5? I guess. Maybe Matt didn't want everybody to have a fire attack in this one. This game's also kind of weird in that Lance doesn't really feel like he has a defined... My dad hit me harder than that when I was a baby. Like, Lance doesn't really have a defined role. He's just kind of halfway between Natalie and Matt. So Lance, like, he's more accurate and hits more times. But that's not always... Like, he has certain enemies that he's good against. I think I'm actually getting a little lag because of my encoding, but it's mostly fine. Or maybe it's just, you know, flash stuff, but whatever. Like, it's supposed to be going at double speed. Look how happy that cat is. I think I forgot to finish this thought, like, 10 minutes ago, but I'm really glad that Matt's still making games, and I'm glad that they found success on Steam, because, you know, I think I went on a tangent after this, but a lot of people really don't, you know, they complain about Flash games and stuff, but I believe at least one, or maybe both, of Epic Battle Fantasy 4 and Bullet Heaven 2 have overwhelmingly positive on Steam, which is really quite rare. Is this not? Oh, I do have a limit gauge. It's just not going up. Oh, I haven't learned my limit gauge or my limit attack yet, have I? Oh yeah, you gotta learn that in this game. Cleaver level 1. Oh right, I want this one. I immediately go for anything that hits more than one target. All right, here's our boss. We're probably all right. Fully healed though. It appears that this guy is the boss. He looks quite different from the other monsters. I'm sure stabbing him will still work. That it will. Here's an even better tip. Don't die. Munch on some kiwi or something if you get tired. Wait, I think poison does work against these dudes. Yeah, it does. I think he might be able to respawn them, but it's still nice to have them out of the way. I think that one might die from poison, so... Yeah, it's really nice to see a developer, you know, sort of build up goodwill and get rewarded for that by, you know, when you finally come to Steam, you know, have fans that buy your games, and I guess that's about it, but, you know, it's kind of a nice contrast to the whole, you know, the whole indiepocalypse and all of that crap. You know, a lot of people... Machine gun nipples. A lot of people just don't have reasonable expectations. A lot of people are really bad at marketing, and I mean, I wish marketing weren't a thing, but it is, and it's important. And even for what I do, you know, it's important to, you know, try to grow and stuff, and I've been trying to, you know, make more shareable stuff and, you know, more clearly communicate my brand, so to speak. Ah, crap. I think coffee is fairly rare in this, but, you know, I'll... Whatever. For purposes of demonstration, I'm gonna allow myself to waste crap. Still kinda weak for his healing spell. I guess we're told onto our fruit until we get it better with a skill. Oh. So yeah, I really like those just-in-time tutorial set of things. Like, free flash RPG and stuff, but it really does a lot of stuff really right in terms of come on, food. Oh yeah, that's way better, okay. In terms of, you know, game design, user experience design, it's really quite impressive. Like, it does a lot of RPG stuff better, like I was saying, than a lot of Japanese RPGs that kind of, you know, just keep their frustrating ways and don't really, like, have a lot of archaic stuff and just erg. So I'm a little iffy on a lot of RPGs. Like, I can't really get into, strategy RPGs that are not Disgaea, because Disgaea just does it so well, and so many other games do it so ugh. Like, permadeath stuff, I don't do that. Like, aw, come on, this is gonna take forever. I forgot he does summon. I guess he only summoned two. But yeah, I know Fire Emblem has a non, permadeath mode now. And I mean, it does change the gameplay. It's not that, like, permadeath is worse, it's different, but it adds a lot of stress, and it's not the sort of thing... I guess we'll scan this guy. It's just not really what I wanna put up with. And Yggdre Union, I really love that game when it's, like... I like the normal combat, I like almost everything except... It is missable city, like, there's so much missable crap, and, it's just completely unfair. Like, you can't remotely 100% that game without a guide. Every item is consumable. All death is permadeath. It's so annoying. It just really harms the game and does not, there's really no benefit to all of the weird shit it does. Like, I don't get it. Should be able to take out both. Well, I already killed one. But yeah, I'll take out that one next turn. I wonder if this... Cast Rock Slide and deals Earth damage. Resistance... Weakness, Earth. Okay. Not bad. Guess I'll kill that thing. Are you weak to fire? Oh yeah, you resist fire, so I guess let's just use the last of that. I really rushed way too fast to this boss. You should not be this weak. But, can I buff? Yes, I can. Thunder, of all things. Did I teach her Thunder? I hope so. Alright. Alright, I guess it's a robot. You know, there's something weird. It's really hard to know before you play a game whether Thunder will be super effective, not very effective, or heal robots. Like, every game is different about that. Like, sometimes their logic is, oh, obviously Thunder, you know, robots are gonna have a way to absorb that. Sometimes, like, oh, it's gonna overload them. So, yeah, don't fight this guy at, like, level 3 or whatever I am. Gotta heal every freaking turn. I guess I should give Matt a beer too. That's the attack buff. I think I'd probably just leave these idiots alive. I guess they only take like one turn to clear. Wait, can I switch team or? Wait, can I flee? You know what? Can I flee? You can flee. Oh, that's one thing. I really like that. In these games, you can flee from anything, you know, there's no requirements to flee. Because, like, it just mean that, you know, alright, I'll come back and then, wait. How do I, oh, I gotta beat that guy. Okay, I'm gonna grind real quick here, and then we'll finish this up. But yeah, just to finish my thought, it's really, like, fleeing. It's really rude that, like, in most games, running only fails against the battles that you actually want to flee, and I really like that you can run from even bosses in this, because it's just kind of rude. Oh, he's got a crown, so you know he's the boss. I really like that, you know, it's one of those things where it's just, it doesn't waste the player's time. There's a lot of respect for player's time in this game, and I really enjoy when RPGs are like that. I think I saw a snake. I don't like it in here. A snake? Did you want to try one? I'll catch it for you. Let's get out of these trees before I get bitten by something. Alright, but yeah, I'm gonna do a little bit of grindy grind. And then we'll be back. Alright, did a bit of grinding. Shouldn't be a problem now. It's amazing how hard the first boss can be when you skipped literally every possible boss or enemy that it was to skip. Something I wanted to show off here. I really like that this game has sort of like swappable, you know, parts for characters. Like, you know, these are all the same enemy, but you know, they have different, and actually I'm gonna run, so hopefully we see a different shield on there. Oh, is that preset? Or no, they're slightly different. Oh, come on. It's a particular shield I wanted to show. Oh, come on, bro. You gotta do me a solid, bro. There you go. Little Hylian shield there. Yeah, I really like how palette swaps get a bad rap, but you know, simple stuff like this where you just, you know, you give a slight variety to the weapons or outfits or colors or whatever of enemies, it makes it a lot more enjoyable and like just feels just an extra bit more fresh. And I really wish more games would do that. You know, people complain way too much about stuff like palette swaps when there's really no downsides, you know? It's not like every palette swap is replacing a full, you know, fully and freshly designed enemy, because, you know, a palette swap costs, you know, I have no idea how to estimate, but, you know, it costs a fraction of, you know, a totally new enemy with, like, new stuff and everything. Hopefully we can kill those one hit now. Aw, whatever. Now we actually have, like, decent attacks and, limit breaks. So yeah, we just, in one turn, we've already did as much damage as we could in, like, 10 turns. So yeah, I was rushing slightly too much, but you know. I actually figured this would take less long than it has. Wait. Earth, alright. I'm sort of misremembering exactly how long this was, pretty meaty game for, you know, cost of free. And you're not entirely seeing the effects of the 2x speed. I think it's because I'm actually double recording this. I was trying to record Copy Kitty. It's a great game, but it hates being recorded. I tried 3 times, 20-minute videos each. And it's like, when I just record a quick test for like 2 minutes, it doesn't do it. But if I record like a whole 20-minute video, like I get like 5 frames per second. It's awful. Oh, one more thing. I really love how this game handles scan. So Final Fantasy X had the right idea in terms of scan, because like way too many games, you elemental skills are all but useless because you don't know what elements work on what things. And like, unless it's really obvious, like honestly it usually is in Final Fantasy X, you just have no idea what skill is good against what, and you never know when to use stuff. And that just really sucks. So that was our first boss. Game doesn't really get too fancy about it. We got all of the forest treasure in the forest. So even despite being, you know, 6 years ago, this game does have all those chivos that modern gamers crave. It's got what plants crave. So we activated our warp point. We get a cute little cutscene here. Poor Nats has a thing impaled on it. I have noticed the musical loops are a little shorter than I remember them, but yeah, early stuff, but not bad. You know, it's vintage. After a refreshing stroll through the forest, battling through slimes and trees, the trio begins to feel their powers returning. It seems as though the monsters of the forest are more aggressive than usual, possibly due to a volcanic eruption in the north. Local legends all aboard Natalie suggest that a demon encountered an ancient god named Akron. Being supposedly immortal and older than the earth itself, the ancestor of this country could only seal him deep within a volcano, carefully hiding the exact location so no one could ever hear from him again. His origins and purposes are still a mystery, for millennia he was forgotten. However, when news of his return spread, many warriors and adventurers headed towards the mountain, each striving for fame and glory. Trio is still a long way to travel before for a party. Before they once again reach the northern mountains. So far, the journey has been quite safe. Luckily, many more powerful foes lie ahead, which provide excellent training on the trio's road to recovery. An eventual recovery of Akron himself. By the way, have you been looking for hidden treasure chests and collecting as many medals as possible? That might be useful someday. Talking to everyone will help you gather hints and side quests and the occasional minigame. Anyway, on to the next area. I actually really like that the game does that. Like, it reminds you to do important stuff, and it's not like all jammed in a single tutorial. This guy with his censorship bar. You know, it's just evenly metered out through the beginning of the game, you know, when it's relevant, and that helps you play. And I really wish more games would sort of like allow themselves to acknowledge, yes, I'm a game, and you know what, you should probably save, you know, just saying, you know, I'm not saying it's gonna be, you know, a major, you know, no point of no return thing, but you should probably save, bro. You know, there's never ever been a time where I was glad a game did not tell me a point of no return is coming up. You know, I don't care how incredibly important your game's story and stuff is. If your game should like either autosave, let me go to chapters, or if it's really a system where it's, you know, save points only and I have to do manually save, tell me before something bad goes down. You know, it's gonna improve my experience by me not being pissed off at you so much more than, you know, that minor immersion break is gonna be, you know? Anyway, this is Epic Battle Fantasy 3. It's on Steam now, and you can go check it out for free. And, oh yeah, Epic Battle Fantasy 5 is still on the way. Like, that was... Heck, I remember talking about Epic Battle Fantasy 4. Like, you know, that was never gonna come out. Now, 5 is in. If you don't follow Matt on Twitter, I believe he's Kupo Games, or maybe at Rizak. Just search Matt Rizak Twitter. You'll find it. Or Epic Battle Fantasy Twitter, whatever. Yes, Google works, Parker. It's important. Parker has opinions. What was I saying? But yeah, he's been posting quite a lot of art for the upcoming Epic Battle Fantasy 4, so if you, or 5. So, if you like to follow stuff like that, go ahead and give him a follow. And I'm also on Twitter. If you like to see, like, cool, weird games, I tend to retweet tons of different stuff. I follow about 1,000 people on Twitter, and almost all of them are devs, so I pretty much always get something cool to retweet. I try to give you some of that quality content. That's right, Parker. See, this is Epic Battle Fantasy 3, and this is Sir Tap Tap signing off.